Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chain Design Channel. Today we are going to discuss about this grid structure ring with all the MIDIs in prompt setting. Are you ready? Let's get started. We are going to starting with the ring size for diameter 16. And we're gonna come over to the right view to creating profile. So we are going to use the stray with the two arm and coming up for whatever how wide that you like to have and going up this one for the thickness that you want. And I basically just gonna copy this curve from here to here. And then we are going to use the arc tool to snapping into the endpoint and endpoint and give it a little bit curve over there. Now let's go ahead to join everybody and have that one to mirror to the other side. And then once we mirror, we want to make it taper. So let's go ahead to make it 3D scale, make it smaller, and to get something like this. Alright, so this is the basic profile that I have for my ring. And here's a very important concept over here for the sweep one we are going to do, because we are going to do the create UV curve. So we need to make sure the seam is on the bottom. So this is what happened. If we use a sweep one rail and we click on here and we click on the top and click on the bottom, and then you click enter and then you click sweep, close the sweep. And you pretty much get something like this, but let's move it on the side and you kind of notice that the seam is actually on the top. We want to make sure the seam is on the bottom. When we create UV curve, we can have a continuum piece. So in order to do that, we are going to use a sweep one rail. We do the same thing, but starting with the bottom and go to the top, and then you click close sweep and then you click OK. By comparison, you're going to notice that now my seam is on the bottom. So when we create UV curve and it won't have a split right in the middle and you have to worry about how the pattern is gonna go together. So this is quite important. So now we have this, we wanna create UV curve and we're gonna click on this one. And so that will be the area that we are going to work on. Explode it into four pieces. And then since we are going to work only on the top of it, so I'm going to divide it this section into four section. And so you can see those points. So I'm just gonna give myself a few lines here as a reference. This is the area we are going to design, and we're gonna design one side and it's kind of mirrored to the other side. And with this, it's going to be also split by those two. So I have this one and this one. With those two, I'm gonna use the divide again to make them into six sections. And again, this is up to you. You might wanna try a few times and see which one worked the best for you. So now I have this, I'm just gonna draw some small straight line here, and that is going to help me to do the blend work. And we are going to use the blend curve. I simply just want to use the blend from this to this and also blend from here to here. Okay, so now we have all this curve. I'm going to make a copy by snapping into those point, and now we're gonna have it come over here, here, and here. So that's how I get those structure. Okay, so we need to make this curve into a solid. The way I'm going to do is I'm gonna pick up all this curve and I'm going to have them extruded straight, and but not in this direction. It's a preset direction. We wanna make sure that it's going left to the right. So let's go ahead to the option over here. Do I wanna have a bullseye? Yes. Do I wanna have solid? No. And the direction is gonna go from left to the right. And how wide do I need it? I may want to have 0.4 millimeter on each side. So I will get the surface like this. Okay, the same thing is going to apply to the other side. I'm going to pick up all those curves. And we're gonna go again, the direction is from the left, the right to the left, or left to the right, and the same thickness. So that's how I get this surface right there. Now we have this surface, we are going to pick up all the single surface that we have there. And we are going to extrude them into solid. So let's go ahead to using the solid, and you have extruded the surface straight. And we want to make sure we have on both top and the bottom. So make sure that you have is thicker than the ring shank that you have, so that way you can do Boolean intersect. Okay, so once we have everything over there, we pick up all the surface coming to the top view. We're just gonna mirror to the other side. So snapping into this midpoint, coming over here to the endpoint. So then we will have structure like this. Okay, so we are ready to flow it back to the surface. We are going to creating the surface right here, snapping to this endpoint, to this endpoint. All right, now let's go ahead to use the command. It's called flow along surface. And we're gonna pick up everybody right here on the top. We're gonna pick up one of the corner, and remember the seam is on the bottom. So we're gonna come over here on the bottom to pick up the corner. Then you can see them is intersect beautifully over there. So once we have there, we are going to only keep the one in the middle that we need. So we are going to use the Boolean split. Everybody over here is going to be split by this ring. So now we can delete all the extra that we don't need over there. And also everything inside of the ring that is an extra. So if I just cut the ring in the half, the boulder is not gonna look right. We're gonna duplicate this edges first, and then we need to have that offset on the surface. So we're gonna offset onto this surface, and we wanna flip it to going in for 1 millimeter. Then you will get this curve here. Okay, so now I have this curve. I'm going to have a mirror to the other side. Over there. Let me pick up all of this and group them and kind of hide it. Okay, so next step that what I wanted to do is I want to extract the IsoCurve on that surface. So we're gonna pick up this surface and we're gonna toggle and extract the IsoCurve close to the quadrant, and one over here, the other one over here. So now we have all those four curves. Now we have those four curves. We're gonna pick up all four curves over there. And that's using the trim command. We're gonna trim off here, and also trim on the other side. And we also wanna trim the one on the bottom. So if we turn the ring back here, we are going to work on with this surface. So let's make a copy of this ring and hiding one of it. And we are going to pick up all this curve and use that curve coming to the top view, trim off everything is not belong there. So this is the surface that we have. I'm going to turn it into the red color, and you can see it is hopping on the original surface. So we're gonna pick up that surface and we're gonna make it into the solid by offset this surface. We wanna offset it thick enough, so let's do 3 millimeter, and we wanna make sure solid equal yes, both sides equal yes. And hit enter, and then you got something like this. Okay, so this will be our cutting object. Let's do Boolean difference. This will be difference out of this one. Okay, so that way we can create a really nice boulder. And we're going to turn on what we had over there, and rest of it is a bunch of Boolean union. And if everything looks nice to you, just go ahead to Boolean union. So you will have grid style looking ring over here. Once you have everything, go ahead to making the setting for the prompt setting. And I have the stone setting video on one of my playlists. They are collecting over there. You can go ahead and watch all the playlists if you want to. Or if you really wanted to know all the detailed setting, I have a stone setting course online. I will list the link at the description below. I hope you enjoy the video. Please like and comment and share my video. That will really help my grow on the YouTube and able to create more video. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.